versus El Kukui, Tony Ferguson.
Some real power shots here.
He's throwing kicks, he's throwing punches.
Oh! He's out!
Oh my goodness! What a fight!
Yeah, that right there is a high-level knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd absolutely loving it. Just... how many more of these his opponent can take.
Massive shot that he landed. Great job.
Just a gorgeous shot there to end the fight. Really just the way he drew it up. He found the opening and capitalized on it to the utmost extent. Nicely done to finish the fight. What a moment for this fighter here tonight. A massive knockout on the sport's biggest stage. Seminal moment for that fighter tonight. Coming up next, it's a welterweight showdown between Jorge Masvidal and Leon Edwards. So here we go as round one gets underway. Two world-class level strikers here, and the expectation is we're going to get a kickboxing match here in the octagon.
Yes, we are going to get a striking match. One guy is very good at kicks. The other guy has unbelievable hands. Let's see what type of attack is going to win the battle of two great stand-up fighters.
Oh, he got absolutely bludgeoned. That's as good a combination as we have seen out of him here tonight.
The last time I saw a combination this good, it was Donald Cerrone beating up on Rick Story.
Oh, good kicks. Beautiful jab there from Leon Edwards. And if you don't know the name Leon Edwards, you're gonna start to hear his name increasingly. Truly one of the better fighters in this division.
Absolutely, and the reason you don't know his name is because he's more of a quiet guy. He's very reserved. He used to be at AKA for months, and you barely knew that Rocky was even there. He was just there to get his work in, as he's doing his work now inside the octagon.
Man, he's just got a great feel for the striking realm early in this one.
The timing is on point. He's doing a great job of mixing everything up.
Well, 25 total strikes have now landed for Leon Rocky Edwards. there as he lands another leg kick in DC. Now we're seeing visible damage as that
leg. He's out!
He's done, he's done!
Yeah, that right there is a high-level knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd absolutely loving it. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Landed flush. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming. So a huge, huge win for that young fighter here tonight. Well, another highlight for the real DC as we look back at that scintillating knockout.
Yeah, but the whole fight, he was landing great strikes, kicks, punches. He was doing everything right until eventually he found the shot that ended the fight.
So a seminal moment for him here tonight as he gets the huge knockout victory. That could hold up as one of the better knockouts of the year.
And gassed you up like you're good enough to be clashing me. Oh, please stop harassing me. Charge me up and put gas in me. Them little fish wanna try a ting. Oh, man, the audacity. I got girl in my ear, telling me lies. Living on the edge to the end of our lives. Infinity, telling me lies. Sometimes I love when my enemy dies. So ahead of my time, mainstream boy starts letting off lie. We can never, ever, ever level in price. Take that fee and then treble it twice. Yeah.
All right, coming up next, a good welterweight matchup here between Jorge Masvidal and Kelvin Gastelum. All right, so here we go with round one, and when you have what looks like a classic matchup of striker versus grappler, it doesn't always play out that way, but given what these fighters said to us on Thursday, the game plan seemed pretty clear.
They're very clear game plans, but which one of them is able to implement the game plan most effectively? The grappler will try to get forward, get close, try to secure takedowns. He's even willing to pull gold. He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
These guys throwing early.
He's done, he's done.
Oh, big left hook there. An elbow. Well, eventually, you know he's going to turn this defense into offense, but he's certainly doing a nice job on the defensive end.
They talk about the feeling out process. He's getting his opponent's timing. Now he's blocking everything. Expect counters as we go forward. Punch over the top.
Educated jab there by Jorge Gamebred Masvidal.
But not even just a jab, right? You watch Masvidal throw that jab. His backhand is always perfectly in place. Nothing is wasted. He's not loading up on his strikes. He's just letting it flow. Jorge Masvidal is a very educated boxer, and it's shown in his performance tonight. It's a beautiful fast foot jab with meaning.
36 total strikes have now landed for Jorge Masvidal. Man, he's just got a great feel for the striking realm early in this one.
The timing is on point. He's doing a great job of mixing everything up.
Oh, look at him land another jab there. He's certainly using that weapon effectively here tonight.
The most effective weapon in all of boxing, in all of combat sports.
A huge strike lands there. Somehow, his opponent stayed upright.
I mean, he's still on his feet, but he's not up by much. Oh, nice combination.
Oh, straight right.
Forget him with his hip into that kick.
Oh, nice check on the leg kick offering there. Lands with the left. The combination lands for him. He is really putting his strikes together tonight.
I mean, he's feeling himself tonight, John. He's doing a great job of putting everything together.
Gamebred gets caught with that punch. He's treading water now. Got to find a way to move those feet. Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
Nice kick. These guys are going at it.
Gastelum gets stung by that leg kick. Oh, Masvidal in a real flow here, sticking and moving. Crowd is like just reacting every time he moves.
Masvidal now has the crowd eating out of his hand. The one thing about Jorge that makes him to deal with.
Whoa! He's
hurt. Throws him up. Go get him.
What an end to round one. All right, there's the end of the round. So it was a huge strike to the head that stung his opponent and nearly got him out of there.
Yeah, that was...
All right, DC, here we go with the start of our second round. Jorge Gamebred Masvidal against that man, Kelvin Gastelum. Gastelum gets tagged with a kick now. Let's see if he can rally. Oh, continuing to work the body to great effect. Good series of punches by him there. He has been busy throughout.
He's doing a great job with the hands. He looks like a professional boxer out there.
Gastelum's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. Back and forth we go. Massive head kick. I'm not sure his opponent knows where he is.
No, he is on Beach Street right now. He's seeing Tweety Bird over the top of his head. You take a hook like that, you are on wobbly legs.
Well, he's looking for that left hand, just out of range, though, with it. Oh, that kick is good by Gamebred. All right, the unofficial numbers thus far, 76 total strikes have found the mark for Jorge Gamebred Masvidal. Wow!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Don't finish this fight.
Crowd loving it. Just a gorgeous shot there to end the fight. Really just the way he drew it up. He found the opening and capitalized on it to the utmost extent. Nicely done to finish the fight. All right, let's rewrap the highlight now, DC. And he's certainly going to enjoy watching this one back. The head kick was there early. It was there often and ultimately ended the night for his opponent.
He found a weakness in his opponent's game. The left kick. Over and over, he was able to land it. And he was landing the strikes, too, with his hands. But ultimately...
It is a welterweight matchup between Jorge Masvidal and Robbie Lawler.
You ready? You ready?
All right, here we go. Round one, outstanding matchup of strikers. Any chance this thing hits the canvas, Steve?
I don't believe so. I think when you have two high-level strikers like you have in these two men, they're going to go to the center of the octagon, and it's going to be a kickboxing match. A kickboxing match that you would see in a ring. Tonight, you get to watch it inside of an octagon.
Well, he continues to stay busy, and he continues to land with volume punches here.
I mean, volume, but he's not wasting anything. He's so accurate out there.
Nice punch by Jorge Gamebred Masvidal. Oh, Masvidal in a real flow here, sticking and moving. Crowd is, like, just reacting every time he moves.
Masvidal now has the crowd eating out of his hands. The one thing about Jorge that makes him so difficult to deal with is he never allows you to trap him. When you think he's got him trapped, try to hit him for a takedown, he evades and escapes. He's a phenomenal fighter. It's a beautiful, fast, quick jab with meaning. He loaded up there on that high kick. Oh, nice right hand.
Back and forth we go. Just over 3 minutes to go. Well, he continues to do a nice job here defensively, protecting his head, raising the guard, and really frustrating the offensive fighter a little bit.
Lesson one in boxing class, hands up, chin down.
Nice punch there by Lawler. So we pull up the stats for you now. 32 total strikes unofficially have landed for ruthless Robbie Lawler. All right, so he continues to use his jab effectively here, DC. He gets that hand to the target pretty quickly.
I mean, just right away.
Back with that offer, DC. He is hurt. And just like that, there is a high-level knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd absolutely loving it. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Landed flush. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming. So a huge, huge win for that young fighter here.